You know, 600,000 women have a hysterectomy every year, but if you're affected by common female conditions like fibroids or endometriosis, there are some new alternatives to a hysterectomy. Six is on call this afternoon with Ochsner OBGYN, Dr. Ellen Kruger. She has more on this procedure. Thanks for joining us, Dr. Kruger. First of all, what is the name of the procedure and how exactly does it work?
This is a procedure called endometrial ablation. It's actually not a new procedure, but there's been some refinements lately with the procedure that's making it much more patient-friendly, able to be performed easily in the office, and it's a very good way to avoid having to have a hysterectomy.
Well, how do you know if it's a good option for you or not? I mean, obviously your doctor would tell you, but...
You have to go check with your doctor. There's some different causes of abnormal bleeding, and you have to make sure that you have a type of problem that would work well with this endometrial ablation. If the uterus is too big, if there's fibroids, if there's an undiagnosed cancer or precancer, then you wouldn't be a good candidate. But for a lot of patients, this is something that's done outpatient, done easily, with a quick recovery, that will keep you from needing to have a hysterectomy in the future. We've got success rates up to about 70%.
But when we say, obviously, if this is an alternative for hysterectomy, then does this mean you will no longer be able to give birth?
Oh, we definitely don't want people to get pregnant after this. The idea of the process is to go ahead and scar the lining of the uterus. So instead of growing a carpet every month, the uterus is scarred and doesn't bleed. But unfortunately, if you get pregnant after the process, that could cause complications. So we recommend someone to have a very secure means of birth control or have had a tubal ligation or type of sterilization before they proceed with this.
So what else would a patient be able to expect after this surgery?
Usually the recovery is very quick, maybe about a few hours in the hospital or a small monitoring time after the procedure is done in the office. Most of my patients, if we do it on Thursday morning, are back to work by Monday.
Could you highlight any risks perhaps involved in the procedure?
Well, you would need to make sure that we know what the cause is of your abnormal bleeding. There's nothing that's precancerous or dangerous. Risks of any type of procedure include bleeding and infection, but it tends not to be much of a problem with this one. This is much safer than some of the conventional therapies like hysterectomy.
Ochsner OBGYN, Dr. Ellen Kruger, great to have you with us this afternoon.
So much.
Good information. And for more information on that procedure, you can call the Ochsner OBGYN department. That number is 504-842-4172.